The verbal crutch, the thing you say way too much, the thing you got to say to yourself, damn it, I got to stop saying that.
Yeah, I mean, does it apply to regular people? I mean, we do it because we're broadcasting, and sometimes you come up with these habits that you do, whether it's to fit, like, as you're thinking.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you do that, ba-da-ba-ba-ba-ba, like that thing you do. Like, I just say a lot.
I used to
say, like, and you know, like all these things, like a like. Somebody says like a lot, or you know.
My original one was you guys. When not speaking with you two, when speaking to the listener, radio is traditionally a singular listening experience. In the car, at home, on the app. Sometimes, like our boy Drew at the factory, back in the warehouse, there might be a bunch of y'all. Love y'all. Stay safe. But you're supposed to say, hey, you listening, you singular. To where an old manager of mine taped a picture of himself to my monitor looking back at me.
A lot of radio managers did that.
Yep.
I found it annoying because I put targets on the listeners.
Yeah, just like a great big crosshair.
Yeah.
I have a tendency during some of the Die Laughing murder mysteries that I'll do. DieLaughingProductions.com or coming to McGoobies December 23rd. I'll go on, you know, fun little improvisational rants to kind of fill time. For whatever reason, I can't help but bring up the subpar road trip eatery Shoney's. I bring up Shoney's 4 shows out of 5. And all of them, rightfully so, will bust my balls for making a Shoney's joke. And that is like a comedic crutch. Something Shoney's. Anastasia. She does a deep breath followed by so, and then a long story also ends up falling out of her mouth. Eric, he does this isn't a verbal crutch that could be annoying. He says, let's be smart before giving advice.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, let's be smart. Ooh, my uncle had one that I can't really get into. It was not kind. Not kind at all. Maybe I'll tell you guys off the air. Let's jump to the phones. Dylan, what's that verbal crutch?
Hey, good morning, guys.
Morning, pal.
Yeah, anytime somebody asks me what time it is, I'm always saying, time for you to get a watch. Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thanks for calling, Dad.
Yeah.
Spigs, what about you?
What?
Now, you have, by the way, this is different than a catchphrase, okay? Catchphrases, you know, it's consistent. It's branding.
Okay.
We wish everyone the very best.
Right.
It's opposite day. That's branding. Mm-hmm. That's part of what you do.
Yeah.
But is there anyone that at the end of the day you go, damn it, I wish I didn't say that?
What I was going to say, and I think this would probably be catchphrase if you know, we're breaking it down, when I go, well...
I like well.
I think maybe, yeah, I don't know if that's...
Nah, that's part of your personality.
I don't know. Do you guys have any you can point out? Do you want?
No, I would never point
out. Zero.
No, you can go ahead.
No.
I'm fine. I'm doing very well today.
Now, hold on. Something just occurred to me. Stamboni on the microphone, please.
Hello.
Yeah, this break was your idea.
Yeah, it was. It caught my eye.
So do you obviously have some for all of us,
Scott's,
I would imagine.
Exactly where I'm going.
Well,
I mean, it's hard for...
Look at me, you son of a bitch.
The person that has the crutch to recognize the crutch. You need to be told about the crutch.
Tell us our crutches.
That is
no,
true.
No. I was sort of thinking about myself a little bit.
Okay.
No, when I first started here, having the learning curve to, like, not cuss on air... I find myself doing like what Scott was at, like, and you know, and I kept doing that. So I had to like still try to break myself of doing
what
that.
What do I tell you? Probably on a daily basis.
He always comes. You always cuss every time I say the F word. He seems to be walking by and hears it. And then we get into a meeting at the end of the day. And what's coming out of your mouth? Just F left and right.
No. Do I use the F word a lot in the meeting?
Sparingly, as needed. Okay. It's not every other.
I tell you, I walk through a bit of a sailor mouth. We work in an office.
Yes, yeah. I know.
And I get it's 98 Rock, but it's also an office. I walk by. You use the F word 4 times in one sentence. I'm like, what are we doing?
Yeah, so you see, it can be a bit of a learning curve.
It is. It's hard.
You have to relearn how to.
Mudge can't talk without using the word Ingus. I mean, just nonstop. It's me trying to be like, hey, we're having lunch with the kids. Stop.
No, I think you guys are pros. I think you've broken yourselves of any of those bad habits.
Not really. No, there's a couple. Another one that I can think of that I try to not, but it's going to dribble out of my mouth before the end of the day. When we're done with the break, I say, stick around. Mm. I try and go, coming up, stick around, on the way, just for a little bit of variety. But it's almost muscle memory where my mouth says it and I don't even think it. Stick around, coming up. We found something weird inside of Bill Vanko.
Now, are those crutches? Or what else are those called? I think that's something else.
Is it a tick?
No, it's just like...
Just calling, like saying stick around?
Yeah.
That's just... You're just using that just like in a sentence.
That's just jar. I don't know.
Yeah, Waldorf Dave, I love you. He cannot make a point without saying all I'm saying is.
Okay.
And
that's,
then 15 minutes afterwards coming dribbling at his mouth. All I'm saying is.
Or just saying.
Just saying. You might as well sit down and get a sandwich and light a cigarette because you're about to sit and enjoy a Charles County TED Talk.
I feel like my dad, every time he... before he asks me or someone something, he goes, let me ask you a question.
Oh, yeah. Let me ask you a question.
Let me ask you a question.
Definitely.
Let me ask you a question.
Every time. Mm-hmm. It's like, just ask it.
Yeah. That's, I don't remember where I was working, but it might have been here. One of our past program directors who said, don't say let me ask you, just ask the question.
I'm guilty of that as well, though.
Yeah. Let's go to Taryn. Taryn, thank you for holding. What's your verbal crutch?
Hi. How are y'all?
Very well.
Hey, how are you?
Stick around.
So I am from Wisconsin.
Oh, cheese.
You know, Wisconsin, you betcha sure.
Lights.
I know.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, now we got the backstory.
So I found this comedian online, and one thing that he says is, oh, just going to squeeze on past ya. And I didn't realize it was a Midwest thing until him.
Just gonna squeeze on past you here.
Okay, that's kind of nice. I mean, it's kind of, like, how many times in a given week are you saying it?
No, too many.
How often are you squeezing past someone?
Oop, I don't even know.
Oh, so wait, it's not even the squeeze on past, it's just
the oop?
It's more of the oop.
It's time for Josh.
I was wondering if she knew. Do you think she knew Jeffrey Dahmer? She was from.
Bring her back up.
And she's right there. Oh, there. Did you know Jeffrey Dahmer at all, Taryn?
Oh, I just squeezed on past him.
Ha! Yeah.
I'm putting her on hold. Give her anything.